this tutorial, I will show you how to stitch a very stylish 2-in-1 reversible cape. For this, I added ribbon so that you can adjust the cape accordingly. This is the front design. The other design you can easily turn out and also can wear it. Definitely this will enhance the beauty of your outfit. So let's see how we can make this. For this I am using 3/4 meter of Japan satin fabric of these two designs. This is an awesome material because it will give very rich and stylish look for your outfit. For this we just need two measurements, that is neck circumference and also the cape length. Based on the neck circumference, we have to calculate the neck radius. For this, we have to apply max formula. Don't worry, it's not that much complicated. So let us see how we can calculate the neck radius. Drafting of miniature version on paper so that it will be very easy for you to understand. Let us assume that neck radius is 2 inches, cape length is 1.5 inches. Fold the paper into half and again fold it. So it's a 4 fold. On the folded side, mark the neck radius, that is 2 inches. It should be like a curve. Take this as a center point and rotate like this. Now for the cape length, top we have to take 0.25 as the stitching allowance. In the same manner, bottom also 0.25. So the total length will be 2 inches. From here we have to mark 2 inches and from here it will be 4 inches. I am taking this point so that it will be very easy for us to draw the curve. Now cut along the dotted lines. I am done with the cutting. Now along the folded line on one side, cut it like this. Should come like this. Repeat the same pattern for these two fabric also. Now take right side of one fabric and mark 1 inch down. This is the placement of the ribbon. First, we have to trim both the edges of the ribbon. Then place right sides together and pin it. Do a stitch on top of the ribbon. After stitching on top of it, pin the ribbon so that it will not come in between while stitching another layer of cape piece. Now place the right sides of the cape pieces together, pin it and do a top stitch. I pinned two cape pieces together. I left a gap of 4 inches at the bottom so that we can turn the inside fabric out. So start stitching from this point. And end up here so that a gap is created. I am done with stitching. Now cross cut the corners. And make small notches all over the stitching area of the cape. Turn the cape inside out from the gap created. By folding the two fabrics and doing a top stitch. After that, make a top stitch and over the entire cape, starting from here and end up here. I am done with the top stitch. After that, I decorated the neck with lace edging.